I want us to continue in that spirit. Let's just allow the Spirit of God to move in us. Let's just feel His presence and enjoy the presence of the Almighty God in our lives. Let's just enjoy the presence. Rabosa. Your spirit sing unto the Lord. Let your soul sing unto the Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit of God. Thank you, Spirit of the Living God. Now we breathe. God is in this place. Is it something fabricated? I don't know, but I know that God is here today. I know for sure that God is here today. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Ke batla hore today re qale ka ho bala lengolo, just few words, and I promise you that I'm not gonna be long, but because monga tsebile tsena o teng ka spile. Actually, where do you want to see yourself in the future? you ask me that question, I'm there. Why, Kishoron? Because I want to be where the Holy Spirit is. Yalehe. If unzong putor na, where do I want to see my future? I'm there. I'm there. I get it, I'm there. Kihonamu, I get it, I'm there. Auna kaika emogili bilete thing. Akore, I'm there. Balbomi kamalengos. I am there. Muruti, just tell us in few words, where do you want to see yourself in the future? No, I'm there. Chatel with me to the book of 1 Kings, chapter 18, verse 42. I am reading 42. So, okay, let's start from verse number 41. And it reads as follows. Bible in Zarona. New King James Version. Second, first Kings, Marana Apili, the Hosita Pili, the Manaya 18, the Manaya 18, verse 41, and then Ufikela, verse 44. Then Elijah said to Ahab, go up, eat and drink, for there is a sound of an abundant of rain. I want you to listen carefully again. Read it for the sake of those who are still struggling to get the verse 41. Then Elijah said to Ahab, go up, eat and drink, for there is a sound of abundant of rain. So Ahab went up and eat and drink. And Elijah went up to the Mount Carmel. Then he bowed down on the ground and put his face between his knees and said to his servants, go up now, look towards the sea. So he went up and looked and said, there's nothing. And seven times he said, go again. I want you to underline every time I'm sharing, go again. Go again, go again, go again. If you did it last year, it didn't work, do it again, go again. If you try to look around, you don't see it. Look again, check again, try again, do again, go again. Then it came to pass seven times that he said, there's a cloud as small as man's hand rising out of the sea. So he said, go up and say to Ahab, prepare your chariot and go down before the rain stops you. Make sure that you are not part of the generation that's going to be stopped. Because the rain is a blessing, but it can stop you if you're not ready. This thing is coming in such a great power that it's going to stop people whom their hearts are not ready to move. Tapelo yaka ke tapelo ya Modimo. I don't want to be that part of the generation sharing culture and tradition that will cause sort of the rain that is coming upon us as the children of God, the revival that God wants to release upon us, or it will stop instead of pushing me. Because Barcelona, many a times when God brings something upon the earth, there's been two different kinds of people. There are people who are ready and they move with God. There are people who held on their traditions and they were stopped and they could not do anything. You look at the mountain, somebody said, I see nothing. I see nothing, even when God has started something. I don't want to be part of these people who say, I see nothing. I want to ask the Lord today to open the eyes of the church. Wherever you are listening to me, wherever you are, want to pray that God will touch you so that you become part of the generation that says, I see from the seaside something arising. It is the size of a man's hand. But size doesn't count when the time of God has come. When God starts to move, size does not count. Size does not work when God is in the move. It is the size of man's hand. But it makes Elijah to say, tell Ahab, prepare your chariot, for something that is coming is bigger than the size that you see it now. You might see it as a size of man's hand, but it's gonna cover the earth. It's gonna cover the nations of the earth. I say, I don't count what I see, but I listen to the sound that I hear. Baratua. Every time when God bring revival, God has never brought anything without sound. Anything is not sound, it is dead. Hakoloya is not sound, it is dead. If the engine does not have sound, it's dead. If your keyboard does not have sound, it's dead. Give me one, how far I'm moving around, it's dead. You get into the aeroplane, there's no sound, it's dead. You get into your car, you put the ignition, it doesn't make a sound, it's dead. You don't hear the sound of the foot of the horse, is dead. You come to the church, there's nobody saying anything. You come and go out, that church is dead. You go to the maternity ward, who told the people they are dead. Because every time when God does something, it starts with a noise and a sound. Touch your neighbor and say, neighbor, I hear the sound. I hear the sound. That tells us all about revival. I hear the sound. From Genesis chapter 1 to Revelation, every time when God moves, there's a sound. Every time they'll hear the sound of the feet of Yahweh walking in the Garden of Eden. There was a sound in the Garden of Eden. Go to the Garden of Gethsemane. You'll hear somebody crying and say, Father, please, this is too much. It was a sound. But Petros Melanhole declares a sound before the Lord for what is about to come on the planet Earth. Sound. You hear Jesus on the cross, Elilama Sabakatani, the shout that makes Urile Fatsili Tutumele Mafika, and the sun stop shining. Sound, where the world that was belonging to the devil and the enemy and the prince of this world was been taken back to humanity by Jesus on the cross. There had to be sound. God never moved without a sound. Conversion. God never moved with no without a sound. Get out the sound here. Get out the sound. Because God moves with the sound. Do. 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 God likes sound. Keops. God God like sound. If you go into the church, there's no sound. No, something is not right. There must be a sound of the word. I hear the preacher saying, everybody who's under the sound of this voice is gonna be safe tonight. Under the sound of the voice, that's where things are born. It's time for revival. I don't want even to say we need, I say it's time. I'm telling you, it's time for revival. It's time. You'll never see it until somebody proclaims. It's time for revival. You can sit like this and open your eyes and find that it's 3 days you have been sitting there. Those are the miracles of signs and wonders that God is going to do in these last days. You will sit like this and the things happen. Yes, them broshka. Do you know there are signs that are going to happen in this move of God? Where people will be here, and when they open their eyes, they will be 10 kilometers away from where they used to be. The miracle of Philip, many, many people did not see that miracle. The miracle of transportation, where God will take you now, and you preach in Kenya, you preach in Japan. When you say amen, it takes you back within 2 minutes without a passport. You see yourself back to the crusade, back to the church in the DR. Those are miracles that we're expecting in the move of God. Miracles of transportation, moving from one direction to another. There's going to be a traffic in the atmosphere because revival has come. It is time for revival. God is going to move in an unusual way. Miracles of transportation. Miracles of appearing and disappearing. We will disappear and appear somewhere else. Because we are living in the agency of time. It's too late. That's why Elijah Ari, prepare your chariot. Go and take it to the measure service. Because it's going to run with a high speed. God is going to accelerate everything that you know. A little thing in your heart is going to be accelerated. The stone in the hand of David and the sling of David, when he released it to Goliath, God is going to accelerate the speed of that stone. God put acceleration to every little thing that you have. Don't be ashamed of what you have. There's acceleration in everything that you touch with your eyes. There's gonna be acceleration. But I will want that to be a whole. That. I can't explain what I fear. I hear the sound, and the sound, it caused sleepless nights to me. In the early 80s, unto Yampa Yampa, why was a Pomodism where they hang in Yana? Eh, Clara Tadina,
ho phumula jolo ka batho ba ba mara ke be ya hlo ya ka mosamo ke re ke ya robala ku tlwa modumo modumo ona kwetsa o ke tswe ka tlhula modumo ona kwetsa di toro tsa ka se tsa tshwana le toro tse tlwaelegile modumo ona o mpontsha lefatshe o mpontsha revival that is coming upon the nations of the world. Udumo wona, umpotsa the church arising to Mount Carmel.
Umpa, udumo.
Uti, Elijah, uti Agabe, he went to eat and to drink. Mara hutu Ahab, hutu Elijah went up and he put his head between his knees. Two kinds of people. Huna le ba yosha, ba revival le fela kinijo, ba revival le humona kinijo, ba religion le humona kinijo. But huna le spato, bere haba uka mutumo, haba aje, ba nyulo watara. I look at any thoughts I want to put into the room. Give a man bow. These are the midwives whom God is going to raise in the church. The midwives who are going to give birth to the things that God has planned for this generation. I pray for the midwives to arise in this church today. I pray for the midwives to arise who will give birth to the revival and stop the revival. Fire of the Holy Ghost that will pass the entire world. I hear a sound. And sound in the ears of Baba. But they get in hope against that group. Babu give a sign, Babu Chabib. The Eastern women. The Eastern women. They give birth. But look at the midwives. But would you want to raise them in 2024? God is raising the midwives. In the atmosphere and give birth what God is giving for them. Yeah.
It is revival.
It is God doing it again for a new generation of people. And I am doing high repeater. It's not a repeater. Bibele ere high repeater. Ore kabona Jehovah. I saw God. Ere bibele bukenya Habakkuk. A prayer of Habakkuk the prophet. On Shikionoth. Oh Lord, I have heard your speech and I was afraid. Oh Lord, revive your work in the midst of the years. In the midst of the years, make it known. In wrath, remember mercy. God came from Teman. The Holy One is coming from Paran. Hey, Hire, God came. God came from Teman. In Hebrew, we call it theophany. Theophany is when God comes, like he's coming from this direction. When by the Spirit you detect God from this side, it was called in Hebrew theophanies. Ukuvela kukaNkulunkulu from a certain direction. It's theophany. I want to say to the church today, there's gonna be many theophanies in our lives today. We will see God coming from directions. God will come from the direction of your family. He might come from the direction of your job that you despise. He might come from a direction of the group that you despise. But this theophany, the coming of God, are going to happen in every one of us. And we've got to watch the appearances, the theophanies of God. He comes from Timan. From Mount Paran. He will come from somewhere. I don't want to lie that he will come from the side, but there will be the coming of God. I sense in my spirit that God is about to revisit his people with revival. You shall be revived in your prayer. You shall be revived in your finances. You shall be revived in your relationship. You shall be revived in your community. You shall be revived. Your dignity will be revived back to you. You shall be revived in your ministry. Give us. We'll give because it's plenty, too much. There was a night when Moses took an offering, and we are getting there. It's uncommon the hell. 3 million unemployed, 100% unemployed, failing. 3 million uncommon the hell. What a very nice day. But Mutara Matoko Ayahumusha, Ule Lakuto is stopped. The time is coming where you will not ask the offering, you will stop the offering. For holy God, look at for what you want. Because when there is theophany, when there is theophany, man is not a thing. You can even give yourself. Because God Himself, the owner and the possessor, has come. His glory, it is His wealth. God's glory is God's wealth. The interpretation of glory is wealth. When we say the glory comes, we say the wealth of God comes. And when God's glory comes, we will all be wealthy. I'm not talking about rich. Richness can be corruption sometimes. We talk about wealth.
soul, spirit, and body. Well, The militaries, the sound of the military, my soul, I think of it. Bana le dithunya dikhomanitse ntse sa khumele mulaya anybody. Dikhumela to threaten the enemies. There will be many explosions, sounds. These sounds are not meant to kill. Sounds is that they are going to terrify hell. Terrify the enemy. Terrify the territories of the enemies. There will be sounds that are terrifying, but what are they? Emotion terrible. Makwana, one side. Ivan Brook, one side. But don't come Isaiah Tibela Dira. It's a Mutira in the air. What you want to fall? But never to regain a prayer. Let's go to the enemies. Four men attack 20,000. And their secret was sound, make a sound to terrify them. Ashando. Now this is terrific, I'm telling you. It's horrific. Shall we sit here? Listen, Sabazaran. But the church is going on. Revival is here. Revival will come in the absence of afflictions. Wabona king, pula haeni husina maru le moya. Kibona le niya. Kibona. The prophet abahana bela baibu. Habari kibona le niya. Kibona le niya. Orle kau nata kapale kau nea. Hagiti bia. Kibona le niya. Hagiti bia ni na. Lea uka kapale uta mai.
Leadership, who are
jungle.
Mani miru.
Kuna mdumo. Asi mdumo wa mafiri tswana. Asi mdumo wa diphiri. O tsalwa ka hara miru. Phiri a re tsabe mo. Le firi tswana ka mahlomo fubedi a re tsabe. Le makanya. But who are the portfolio specializing ka sound? If we hold, if you go to the prophet and me, that's all. When I carry can say pure human hair, or fell off them, you know, kill a lion. What's a lion here? Take a voice. Hide. All the animals stable do a fast. I did you wake him to have the work for his sound. Then that's about me. Come on, you take an example. So I didn't take a water. I want to water to eat a lawyer hell level. How water to have a strong way? We eat a pipe on way a hell level. But I run time. Imagine I just number Sadi and Ivan. Get rat as I own church as I own. I can't write a little about if one lady can't give it. That's good, Isaba. How about that? Do I run time in the room? And make sure we get the right by increasing. Batla iran thai. Tsena tse hlo e kgolo. Dintle ka modumo. Ke moruti. Budget.
Ke mo budget. Ba re ke ba rata.
Budget.
Ile ma.
Moruti na go ile.
I'm going to go to the house.
There's a sound. May the Lord raise a generation of midwives who give birth to this in Jesus' mighty name. May God raise a generation that will look towards the sea and say, Inyani, Maragia is born. Inyani, Maragia is born. In Jesus' name. Honorable son. Man in the jungle, lions sound to intimidate the victims. Said in the phone at the rara, you know, lion is a fish. Maramutumo. Kambon, the cousin. Obano Mongura Kobi. Enthusiastic on my feet. How to salute ability? Bafola Gaji. Yababasu. Very old now and not well, over 80. Predicted to a two, but only met only 10 months happy. And the kind of woman gets a mic, same as the same car on a high, but it's never the total name. The total name, the Lamahalani. It's about 10 kilometers, Reabuji. Musali masa kono mupenda. Ene na kika ena kono jistika ba jimu pepis. Marubi chana. Kinka muhula nwa kiki bata wami. Mana mnyare. Ajwa kimu chata vita ba jimu nini nixi. Tama aje. Unza ukota zari ah. Mara fita mono. Taibo ona tupeza. Ena kia uzi. Kia uzi ba. Tama na mane. Mana mnyare. Kia uzi ba. Karasa futu metsi metsi. Futu metsi mtandu. Sabi ya metu una ningi taba nini. Karamuki yeni. Ede mule mwenyaku wanika ama bauto lana we. Mamuki yeni. Ile mama suki zaani. Ile mwenye. Paralije mwenye. Kubatlea. Kubatlea batu wangu la mwenye.
No, in the revival. revival, it's revival of the saints. Because it's time for revival. Juele uri how about moba fitla holy green haba fitla kilo wadata haba fitla hukwetika le bota ba jamba le bota haba le kose haba change the constitution ba jamba ka muhalo hai ne ukwetzi munyago ba ya festering how ukwetzi festering ba kena ka di air bricks yolo ka mihontwane o tla bona on a coffee table ba sanbonana sanbonana
sanbona
ha o ke le kaya rona re mbisa ha re batho ba protocol re kena mo kwetse re tswa mo kwetse abare joela ke tla tsena na mayo ke tla kala gardening I will baptize them with my spirit. That time, young and old, they shall prophesy. But prophet, they'll prophesy. But I don't know what I'm saying. But I don't know what but prophet are non-stop. The more than to take it to one, I can only pay that. I'll get that. I'm a call on the fatty. Mika. Mona fatty, I will do signs. And one, I will heal. I will do cosmic miracles. Miracles in the atmosphere. It will change the atmosphere. The holy radio will come out. It will toss back up again. It will blow the minds of the scientists. And the answer will be the church. It will restrain the force of gravity. It will and walk on the sky. When I was in Bachelor, I tell her for Barbara, the daddy. The time of revival, even the force of gravity will not hold us forever. Do you know when Jesus appeared? Force of gravity for the first time it ever ran through. We will fly away and just greet Jesus as if how man terrible. Revival is here. Can see my work and to see me. But I reckon you are getting so fair. You don't do more. Can you go to the Mosadia Mamela and put in next? Natalie Malafo. What a man would you want to put on you about the quizzes? I got a little bit one can alone one talk, say, can get never myself. The total year I can get that form of Samuel Hilsiki. Hilsiki is Finland. I'll be there. You know, I'm sure about how. Who do you hike Almanaga in the Tamati? Who work up with Hilsiki? No stone. Balonia, they have a royal fat. What is that? They're going to go with. I'm going there. To do what? To be part of the revival. That's what I'm saying in Zigbee. But a revival. How about the revival I said? King Kapeche. Yasasa. Sasa, one revival.
Our appearances will change even situations. Because this anointing and glory, sometimes it becomes too much to tolerate. Church Botwaga Ilan Tibe, Karikia Katu. Church Botwaga Ilan Tibe, Karikia Katu. Because that day, there was 40 days fasting, the fasting about that thing, 21 days fasting, and that thing kit. The late with that thing kit. It's like a fasting.
I get it again. What are these things telling to your children? And your children tell them to their children and the children of their children, so that it must not be a miss, there must not be a missing link. Orlando, Kareboli Muna today. Longulungulu asimboni namsha. Labriana Kuni Sakaria. Asha!
Pending Are you really crying for it? Are you really groaning for it? Are you seeking revival with everything? Three. Power of revival. In revival, there's power. And that power is not your power. It is the power of revival. In revival, God takes over in his sovereignty. It is the sovereignty of God that overrides the humanity's activities. In revival, and do things that were humanly impossible. Revival is sovereignty in action. That's why in revival, something can just happen that you do not know where it comes from. In revival, when the revival is there, in one of the revival, Mutula Shelwa Kiper. We shall raise the dead, not say but in the name of Jesus. You can't go around and pray for horses if there's no revival. Sometimes we reclaim a revival when we are dry. Sometimes but what claim the resurrection of the dead when they don't have revival. Scanna to Sabatum, Clouds are about to work at a matata. Had to see what to work at a matata. Is a mutation that comes about give up to one fight the epidemic. And of one of them, one more for the large juice. But during the revival, those are the sovereign. They are happening with by the sovereign will of God. Tato Yabutu is to demonstrate his glory to the earth. God is demonstrating his glory in revival. Memu, you'll read your books, especially those who are reading the books of God's generals. Memu Laema Medica is hard at all. I said to a statue for 3 days. Thousands of people came, but not a stage. How did you think it is enough? A calamity is a man out there to up himself. You know, around about 2 minutes, I don't want a melody to fall down. Stage, you see. In one of the plays, a man called Charles Finney Nafita Catherine. He's a Tony Samuts, but power can't grant him. A Tony Satrini. Not just the power of man is revival. Had to a station in Barbara Day, but a chance for you to feed them. How can I care for the kind of chips? How can I shape car? How can I shop for you? Shop for your car? Because everybody's falling on the streets. Cars, the gym, the robot, how not the whole color and whole thing. What's what's that? Hamisema to our whole so uncle is on a chase. He went to the factory of 3,000 people in Germany. How savage, but how can you fight my way? They go fair. But Finney, by two of you are not Habab religious, but our chosen Emma, for God so loved the world. Habakatawa Melajesu, Michinia Jelatini, the whole factory, Mohon Munayana Bakao Fela Bonadi, they surrender to Jesus and they serve Jesus. It's a revival. Those miracles were not recorded. I'm saying extraordinary miracles will happen now.
extraordinary miracles that have not been recorded are about to happen. That's power of revival. There are certain things that you can't practice if there's no revival. We need to pray for revival. We need to pant for revival. Then we'll see the power of revival. Number four, people of revival. In every move of God, there are people of that move. There are people who are slow learners in revival. Babona revival as a disturbance of their program. They cannot go. Many countries because revival was becoming disturbance to their program. You go to Europe, you go to America and other big churches that I know. Then there's now over 25,000 people attending. They are dead today. Not about the Hero Auditorium. What killed revival in that particular church? Because the revival was against their program. They tried to stop it so that they can behave right. And revival left. Revival has people. The people must fear God. Yes. The people must be people of faith. Yes. The people must be people of prayer. Yes. The people must be people who forgive one another. Yes. The people must be the people of love. Yes. The people must be the people who hear God. The people must be the people of obedience. Those people are the people who will walk with God in revival. Because they are not going to question God. When God says do it, they will do it. When God says let's go, they will go. They will sing like the singer says. Whatever you do in this season, don't do it without me. People of do you want to be a person of revival? Do you want to be a people of revival? You can be today. You can join the move. You can walk with God. You can surrender your life to God. But I want to be there when the saints shall march in. Prayer of revival. Painting of revival, power of revival. Number four, people of revival. Five, problems of revival. One of the things that will make people to reject revival is because they were not taught that there are problems. When revival comes, there will be a generation that comes and imitate revival. That most of the people will reject it because wrong people have entered into holy sanctuaries. I was preaching in Kenya in 2000, sometimes I don't remember. Then they took me out of the outside Nairobi. How do you feel like I'm going to Nairobi? I'm going to N1. I feel like I'm going to Nairobi. Between Nairobi and Uganda. I'm going to N1. But then, I'm going to feel like I'm going to this book. I smell Nairobi. But I come on a Yamo Sudan, Ido Fella, Cairo. The longest road. I hear me more about Halau Shevella, the poor follow the immigration, them going from another country to another. The end thousands got a benefit. But I'm telling you, you know, you know, you know, you know, but when the river before the Yaka Tanzania, the mud, the Balela season. But I didn't think about Kenya, Tanzania, the Tashela Karanukayo, the Atsila, the Yaka Tanzania, the Tsela Tanganyika. Now, but Hadi Tselanuka, all these crocodiles that go on the Nile River, Bo Victoria Lake, Kaufela Yatamaya, the Yano Kenyu, the Yela season. Mara hadiele sizini, diela sizini ya ulo jam, pao folo te jam belang to their season. Baga di kempa mo ma 2 weeks, di crocodiles. Hadi fitla mo, hadi pao folo di ken. So nadi bizi ya hunda.
ye makantle biaja
ho tsona ke season ya o ja tsedi ha di tsela mo di tsela di sna maoto
para di entse le ruwe o ba neng ha o sana bo philo ka nkani di tshelela ka mona ka mo le green ka dina hentsa bo se Tanzania
tsedi ha di khone o tshela ke mmeleng ntate o tshela mmefela ntate ha sa tshela to immigration
mara ho tsane ke time to eat from that immigration
baba mbona ke nako ya o ja season
baba ng highly season ya o jumpa baba ke nako ya o ja ba ke neng ka ra season ba qete we must be careful there are problems in revival
they will come to revival but to eat
what is produced by revival.
That's why every time when there's a revival,
there are problems of wrong people into a right season. And I don't want you to be part of that. I don't want you to be part of that. Eating in somebody's season.
How did you like a man in telling my son and the family? Do you know in your season yet so no matter this I said my family. Tseding a dina maoto ke di crocodile tse tlileng fela go tloja
somebody a season ya e fitlhileng
those are problems of revival we've got to guard ourselves with the word of God and be sensitive to what God is saying sensitive to what people are saying and sensitive to what the spirit is saying because if we are not careful the devil will take advantage of us in our own season out of my name tonight number of the problem of revival are going up price do you know that revival is a money price here you've got to pay price for revival criticism but what about criticizer some will say you are insane out of your mind why do you do this when you're supposed to do this and you will have to refuse some people that you love in order to be part of the life some of you even in your church will be changed because that church does not have capacity to contain the Bible but I want to tell you here in Gospel Fire I go wait you have capacity. I go wait since we go to a feel home we have capacity. We can handle you if you want revival. We can handle you. We can handle you. Right. Lastly, the place. What the place of revival. Revival is like a lightning. It hit that place. It go and hit the place. While you're not able to walk on, you're not able to sound clean. There are places on the ground that attract the lightning. There are places, there are things that attract lightning. How do I know? No education. Nova science akirona le tutotsa tractor le le nova bomba lo basuto wa ile patale bese patale bese la ngai fa sa ke tsheo ba tlwe le ke science ya basuto fela they know that there are things that attract lightning se fate sena sa a willow tree se dula pela metsi advice go sky makatla sa tsona when it's raining because they attract lightning there's a place for revival I pray that today we'll to say Dalekhai and all the men of God here conference I pray may this gospel fire be a place that can attract God's lightning is.
May this place be the place that will attract God's lightning. I stand today. I came to look at you, to give you look at God. Make all efforts that your place will be a place that attracts God's lightning upon it. In all programs that you do, in all plans that you do, make the place to attract the anointing, the revival, and the lightning of God. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, I close by saying, after 9 times I close, now I close. Be ready to send me to do prayer. I can't pray. I don't want to pray. It's too heavy for me. But I want to say this. Let us be available. Availability, not ability. That whenever God wants to strike with the Holy Spirit and His revival, may you be like a willow tree. And attract all the good things that God is doing in your life, in your church. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, I thank you.
Prayer of revival. Moruti says prayer is birthed in the revival is birthed in the oven of prayer. He says when they had prayed, the place was shaken. Number two, panting of revival. That is the deep desire, to desire deeply, yearning and longing for revival. The third one, power of revival. It is when God takes over, when His sovereignty takes over. It is when the supernatural takes over. That is the power of revival. Number four, the people of revival. In every move, there are people of that move. People who will obey. He also mentioned a time ago the people of fire. Revival in Samaya Libatu. And I'm here to tell you that you are the people of revival. God has selected and appointed you to be the people of revival. Number five, the problems of revival. There will be people who will imitate revival. There will be people who take advantage and abuse the season of revival. Hababona people who are going into their season, they will come and be a hindrance. Kapohuja bakena kahara season ya bona. That is the people, the problems of revival. It's wrong people in the right season. There will always be wrong people in the right season. These are the problems of revival. And he mentioned the price of revival. Revival ya batalwa. One of the prices that you have to pay is criticism. Because the things that happen during revival, people will not understand them. And people criticize what they don't understand. That is the price of revival. And the seventh one is the place of revival. I'm here to tell you that we are in the place of revival. Right here, we are in the place of revival. Let us carry this revival. Let us stand up on our feet and let us just pray and thank the Lord for this wonderful word. We thank the Lord for this powerful word. Lord, whatever that you are doing in this season, don't do it without us. We are the people of revival. We are in the place of revival. We are ready to face the problems of revival. We are ready to experience the power of revival. We are longing and desiring revival. And we are ready to pray for revival. I want you to take a minute, and just speak to the Lord. I want you to confess. Say, Mudimu, what you are doing, do it without me. I want you to present yourself before the Lord. Each and every one of you. It's not a prayer that we can only pray for you as the church, but you as an individual. Let it be your prayer. I want you to take 2 minutes and just present yourself before the Lord and say, Lord, use me in this revival. Let me be part of this revival. I surrender everything to you. I surrender myself for this revival. I surrender my gifts for this revival. I surrender my resources for this revival. Anything that I need to do to be part of this revival, I'm ready and willing. Take 2 minutes and just pray. Take 2 minutes and just pray. 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 I want to be part of this. I don't want to be left behind. I don't want to be one of those who will be looking from outside, looking from the window, sitting inside, looking outside when things are happening. I want to be part of it. I don't want to be the one who will be pointing a finger at revival. Because when you point a finger, sometimes you become barren. When you point a finger at something that God is doing, you become barren. When he pointed a man of God who was praying to the Lord, who was doing something that was unusual, he pointed and laughed. And the Bible says the Lord closed a womb. You don't want to be one of those people who will point at the revival, but you want to be that person who will be part of the revival, who will participate in the revival, and by so doing experience the power, the supernatural power that is in revival. We thank the Lord. And as you conclude praying, begin to thank him. Begin to thank him that you are already, by hearing this message, you are part of it. By hearing this message. Because you could be one of those people who are sitting at home. You could be one of those people who decided not to tune in, decided not to come, decided to just do other things. But the fact that you are here and you are listening to this message, listening to this prophetic utterance, it means already you are part of it. God appointed that you should be here. It was in the mind and the heart of God and in the plan of God that you should be one of those people who will hear this message, because you are part of it. Begin to thank him for making you be part of this. We thank you, Lord. As we are still standing on our feet, if you are here, you do not know the Lord Jesus Christ as your Savior. You have not received Jesus
I have not decided to rekinke morena Jesu personally ibe mophulutso bophelo baka. I've not made a decision. I want you to lift up your hands wherever you are and say, I just want to make a decision today to receive Jesus as my Lord and Savior. Ke batla ho pholoswa ke be ngwana Modimo. Let me see your hand if you're there. Just wave it so that I can see you. If you're saying, I want to receive Jesus as my Lord and Savior, is there somebody? I see a hand here. I see one hand here. Is there, let wave it so that I can see it. Wave it so that I can see it. With all due respect to Baotla Kapil, when they are permitted to talk to Baotla Kapil, if you know about Kapil, just ask your neighbor how to feel it. If you know you are afraid, ask your neighbor. Is there somebody who's still coming? Don't be afraid. Don't be ashamed. This is the best decision that you have made. Bless you so much. Thank you, young man, for a great decision that you've made. I want you to raise your hands and lift them up towards this young man. I'm going to just help you pray. Lift up your hands and you will say this prayer after me, because I know you might not know what to say. Say this after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I thank you for your word. I thank you for speaking to me. I stand before you today as a sinner, and I'm asking you today to forgive me of all my sins. Wash my sins away. And today I believe with my heart and I confess with my mouth that you are Lord of my life. Lord Jesus, come into my life and be the Lord and the Savior of my life. Today I confess and I declare that I am a child of God. I am saved in the name of Jesus. Father, I pray for this young man. I present him before you. May the Spirit of the Lord come upon him. May the Spirit of the Lord fill his life, protect him, watch over him, lead him and guide him. We dedicate this soul before you in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. I just want you to do me a favor. Just go to he just wants to take your name so that we can pray for you. As we come into the end of the service, I know some of you have not given. I want you to quickly come and bring your offering as we are concluding. I know hi mona renela ka sporofita rutwa recha re anehela, but if you have not done so or you still want to give a bit more to the Lord, just stand up quickly and just come and give your offering. Bring your tithe also. You can bring your tithe. And how to stay karula bushume, just come close to me so that I can just speak a blessing upon your life. Amen. Ademen, come out too quickly. Let's bring that offering. If you have done your tithe, or last week you at least it was carapella or something, just come. We have a speed point on the right there. If you want to give, maybe you don't have cash, just quickly go to the speed point there and then we're gonna